Why, hello and welcome everybody. It is Pox again. So today I kind of want to go over and keep you guys updated a little bit with what's been going on with me and PoE. I haven't really gotten to play it too much since I got back from PAX. I don't know if you guys know this or not, but sometimes it's a little difficult to jump into a game where if your character dies, then he's gone forever, especially when you're level 98, almost to 100. But let's talk about that. So there's about 3 weeks left in the league, and we're about a level, I don't know, we're still basically two levels away. We're pretty far away from hitting level 100. I feel like I want to push for 100. The problem is the way I want to level to 100 takes a very long time. And the reason why is I have a lot of fun running my Double B on Shores. I'm sure a lot of you guys have tuned in for some of the content when I'm running them. The problem with running a Double B on Shore is if you're running this solo, because I don't run the support, then I need to acquire all of my sextants. So I need about 10 yellow sextants every 3 maps, and about 1 to 2 red sextants every time. So that's 10 journeymen, I think they're called journeymen, and then about 2, usually 2 masters. Acquiring my shape shores isn't too bad. I can sustain them pretty well. The problem is since the league is going, further and further into like the abyss state, I call it the abyss state, which is kind of like about 3 weeks into the league on hardcore, the economy kind of dies because most hardcore players stop playing. The softcore leagues are completely different. I don't really know what happens with those. But it just becomes a lot more difficult to acquire currency and continue doing what you're doing normally. So things get much more expensive. As you can tell, I used to have like a fatty 1.5k chaos stack, and now it's just going down rather than up because it gets so much more expensive to roll the maps. Nonetheless, though, we do have a backup strategy. My backup strategy is I still have, I don't even know how many strands. I have a lot of strands, like quite a few strands. The reason why I haven't really been running my strands and I've been trying to sell them is because Blight is not really a clear speed skill. To be honest, it's pretty shit. Because of that, in my opinion, the shape strands are not as good as running for me as, another build, for example, because it'll take me 5 times, maybe 10 times the time to clear it than a Vol Spark does, or just in general, something that can kill very quickly. So that's why I kept my shape strands to kind of sell off to try to generate more currency for my other maps. I do have a bunch of tier 14 coves. So this is probably about, let's see, there's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. This is probably like 8% experience, maybe closer to 11% if I get really good rolls on them. So I'll see if I can probably run these shaped shores or shaped coves and get some returns as well. So that's definitely something that I'm trying to do because it's a lot of fun to try to sustain your map pool for what you can. I get a lot of, I guess I get really happy when I'm able to sustain pretty much everything myself because it just feels kind of good. It feels like you're playing kind of self-found when you're not really playing self-found. But anyway, let's move on to some other projects. There's still like 10 builds I want to create, but I'm not going to have enough time to create them. I do have an elemental hit build that I want to play. I don't want to reveal too much information about it because I don't want to play it until I get bored with my Blight guy, or again if I want to take another break. But we only have 3 weeks left of the league ends, and I'm not level 100 yet, and I made this character day one, so hashtag longest road to level 100 that's ever happened. I also need a restock on my supplies for my sacrifice pieces because these add the quantity bonus, I believe, or rarity. I've been holding all of my divination cards. I wanted to turn them in ultimately either when I died or hit level 100. If you guys want an example of some of them, let's pop up some common ones. We have Gambler here. I've got a total of 190 Gambler cards. I know there's a Beyond one in here. I have 128 Calling cards. I guess I could just go down this list a little bit here. Anything? Oh, that's cool. I've got a Free Will Toxic, some random Dagger. Six Link Holy Chainmail. 2 level 19 skill gems, that's pretty shit. A Dodre item. 2 item level 100 body armors. Some pretty interesting ones. I guess most of these are shit, but there are some pretty cool ones. Shav item. That's 40 chisels sitting there for me. Screw these Carrion Crows. Some Enlightens, almost Vivid Crimson Jewel. Some of these look so cool. 41 lover cards. You could actually get a crystal belt from these, I believe, which is pretty nice as well. I don't know what else there is. Oh, I almost have a full The Wrath. I don't even know where that came from. the Wretched. So that's looking pretty cool. I do have another set. I'm sure you guys will like this. I don't think I'm going to make a YouTube series out of it this time. Maybe I'll just take the highlights and put them up. But again, I have a fucking ass ton of accessories for running maps. So if you guys want to tune into this, this is going to be happening today on the stream. Probably maybe a couple hours from this video going live. And I'll try to sell this all off like I did with the other ones. So like quite a few of the other ones didn't actually sell. A lot of the jewels sold. Well, actually, these got restocked over and over again. A lot of these shitty rings, these rings sold for the most part. But I need to liquidate all of that stuff out as well. I also am still doing pretty good on the maps. I've got a shit ton of promenades to run for tier 14s. I also have some courtyards, which are tier 15s. And then I don't have too many Minotaur maps. And the reason why is those mainly drop out of tier 15 maps or tier 14 maps, primarily tier 15s. And I don't really run too many tier 15s because courtyard is pretty cool. But when you're doing like double beyond courtyards, because I was doing them, double beyond courtyards with like six sextants, it was really sketch. Like I was getting hit for like 7k by like random shit. And I was like, what is even going on here? Yeah, so I think that's pretty much going to be the goal for the guy, is I really am still having fun, and I think I do want to push for 100, because this even has my signature name, man. This is Pox, dude. So I think it'd be cool to get a level 100 character. I might switch to Essence Drain. I don't think I will, though, because it'll be kind of fucking annoying, because it's like a complete... I would change so much stuff, because I wouldn't use a Zergal's Crank on my character. So I think I'll just continue to stick with Blight. And I'll see if I can just try to push some more hours, because I've only been streaming PoE like 4 to 6 hours a day. Maybe you'll have to jump back into like 10 hours, or maybe even play off stream. So we'll see what happens with that. But definitely is a goal I want to keep pushing towards. And I think that's pretty much about it. Yeah, if you guys want to see, I was going to make a fire trapper. For quite a while, actually, I wanted to make a fire trapper. And I tried getting a level 21 fire trap because nobody is selling fire traps, because for people who don't know, hardcore economy is pretty much dead in Path of Exile. I bricked 14 fire traps trying to get a 21-20. That did not ever happen. I don't really know why. That's pretty shit luck, to be honest. But hey, I mean, that's kind of just life. I do want to stay as well. I'm not bored with Path of Exile whatsoever, so when the next league comes, I'm going to be super stoked for that. I cannot wait to play an overpowered skill, or maybe something that's hidden OP and not Blight, because I'm not bored of Blight, but I cannot wait to play something that, you know, you put money into and it just scales exponentially. Blight is kind of like, it's shit. Okay, you have AoE, it's pretty okay. Alright, you put in 100x into your character, it's alright. I can't wait to play something else that's just, you know, just synergizes so much better with other things. But defensively, I do have to say, this is a very defensive character, and I'm very happy with the way it turned out. And I cannot wait to see what happens next league, because I can't wait to create something really, really fun, and potentially play it as my main again. I might even go for something bossing-based. I've never played Essence Drain before, but I kind of want to move away from maybe like the CI Chaos meta, but at the same time, it's so strong, and sometimes playing things that are strong is fun, because that's kind of just how it is. So we'll really have to see kind of what happens. Definitely, I want to try moving away from fucking rolling my flask like this the whole time, but I don't think we're going to be able to get away from that unless they literally change something with the core mechanics of the game, which is not going to be happening anytime soon. But yeah, kind of just some updates as to what is going on. Hope you guys had a wonderful time. Hope you boys have enjoyed yourself. And as always, I'll see you guys all tomorrow. So take care, have a wonderful time, and thanks for watching.